Before we start these awards, we should first proceed by thanking all of those who helped us put together the speaker series and the Get a Bigger Wagon Awards. Thanks to Audra Bellion for her artwork, Terry Ellington, our go-to camera guy and editor, the Edwards team of Natasha Ketchup, Tyler Case, Anna Burton, Megan Cantwell, and Brandon Johnson, and a big hug to my wife, Maureen, and business partner who spent days, and I mean days, on all the paperwork and follow-up with all the contestants. Finally, special thanks again to the boss, the big guy, Dean Willoughby, for allowing us to do this and to push forward our decades-long quest to have entrepreneurism as a major at the Edwards School of Business. Keith is the sixth dean that I've been working on to try to make this happen. I know he's going to come through for us. Now, the goals of the Get a Bigger Wagon Awards are pretty simple. To expose the idea of entrepreneurism to young people, to encourage them to start companies, to reward them with recognition and good old cash for their outstanding ideas and hard work. The awards are divided into four categories: 7 to 9, 10 to 12, 13 to 15, and for the first time, a new 16 to 18-year-old category with a $1,500 prize. We also have a new recognition award for people who promote entrepreneurship in the community. The award is called Sailing the Entrepreneur Ship. And the plaque award will recognize the captain of the ship, and the $1,500 prize will go towards their project and its development. The 2020 winners have been placed on this plaque beside me, and the plaque will be displayed on the wall at the Edwards School of Business by our speaker series wall once the pandemic is over. An additional benefit of the Get a Bigger Wagons Award is to expose young entrepreneurs to successful business people by attending our speaker series, which this year will be streamed in January, along with this presentation. Once the pandemic is over, we hope that you will visit the U of S, and in the future, attend the Edwards School of Business and develop your business skills and be better prepared to start your adult entrepreneurial adventures. We would also like to thank all the young entrepreneurs who sent in their entries. As usual, we had a really hard time deciding who the winners would be, and we would encourage those who did not win this year to enter again in 2021. We had three winners last year who entered twice before they won. Your certificates for participating have already been sent to you in the mail. So I think that this time, Terry, we should start our first categories. But now it's the fun part, the awards. And unlike other award ceremonies that give you a check, we give you cash. And that's a lot more fun, as you can already see. I would like to have Maureen, the director of all facets of the awards and author of our Get a Bigger Wagon entrepreneurial books, to come up and help with the presentation. Now, the first group, oh, look at this, money fell all over the place here, sorry. The first group is the 7 to 9-year-old category. And here it is.
Hello, my name is Mary Kinder and I am 9 years old. I'm in grade 4 and I have a
birthday. And we are the Three Sweet Queens!
That's awesome. Now, would the ladies please come up, Elise and Maria, come on up. And we want you to come over to the little microphone there. And I'm just going to, while you girls watch, so you can check up on my math, I'm going to count out your money to my wife, okay? Before we count the money, what are you girls going to do with your cash?
We might buy a trampoline or some more animals for the farm.
We might buy a trampoline. And are you going to split the money with your mom and dad?
We have to give them some for the coop and stuff, so yes.
Oh, good for you. Paying for your expenses. Well done. Well, I'm going to count it out, and then we're going to put it in the wagon, and Maureen will bring it over, and you can take it back to your table, okay? So 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, 350, 400, 450, $500. Do you like orange? Yeah. Good. Okay, we're going to put it down there. And you girls can take your, each take a bundle. Thank you. Get cracking, ladies. Maureen, you could give it to Maureen because she has a mask. We want you to realize this bribe was given to us after the presentation, not before. Do you want to take those eggs out of there, sweetie? Yeah. Just put them where I won't step on them. Have egg on my face or foot or whatever. All right, now we're going to go on to our second group, and that's the 10 to 12 years old. And Terry, would you play the clip?
Hi, my name is Will Gust. This year I started a chicken business to pick up some money.
Being a farm kid is being the ultimate entrepreneur. Our life is full of jobs and helping out. That's what our family is about.
Hi, my name is Maya Max. My business is Reverse 7M Cattle Company.
My name is Emily Clem. I'm the owner of EK Bakery in Lumsden, Saskatchewan.
These two steers I will feed all winter and sell in the summer.
Now, come on up, Maya, Mackie, and let's give you some cash. Did you bring your cows with you? No? Somebody looking after them for you? If you go speak in that mic, who's looking after your cows?
Dad and my little brother, Rio.
Wow, that's good. Good to have help, eh? All right. And what are you going to do with your $750? Sorry.
I'm going to save it up for a sewing machine, maybe.
Oh, you're expanding into a new line of business as well?
Yeah.
Oh, good for you. So you better watch me, Kate, to make sure I don't cheat you, all right? All right, here we go. 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 750. There we go, and here's your award. And thank you very much for all your hard work.
Thank you.
Can you get Bob? There you go.
And you came from quite a long ways, didn't you? Yeah, and we tried to give you warm weather, but it never works. It doesn't matter if it's December or January. We always have cold weather. All right, the next category, if my wheel man is ready. You need some WD-40 on that thing. I hope that's the wagon squeaking. Yeah. All right, the third group is the 13 to 15-year-old category, and Terry will play that.
I'm Will Blakely. I'm 13 years old. I'm an entrepreneur from Console, Saskatchewan.
Hello, everyone. I'm the founder, CEO, seamstress, and marketer girl of Tan Co Apparel.
Hello, my name is Odin Kozer, and I am 13 years old. I am the proud owner of Oaks Nachos and Cheese.
Hi, I'm Quinn. I'm 14, and I help people bring their memories back to life. I live in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, and I'm part of a big family of six.
My name is Minjong Kim, and I am a grade 10 Korean-Canadian student residing in Regina, Saskatchewan.
Hi guys, my name is Emma Bros, and I am the owner of The Wild Lilac.
Hello, my name is Carson Palmer, and I'm the owner of CP Sheep Farms.
I'm Quinn, I'm 14, and I help people bring their memories back to life. I live in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, and I'm part of a big family of six. One day, my dad walked in the house with his old VHS tapes and said, "We should watch these as a family." And I was asking him, "We can't watch those, we don't have a VCR." And that's how Flashback Digital started. So with this new cool idea that we had, we needed to brainstorm to find a name. So, after lots and lots of working to find out what we wanted, we finally came up with Flashback Digital. So we thought it'd be cool to have a logo that was retro. So we were thinking of using one that was similar to Back to the Future. We started doing our research and we made a website called flashbackdigital.ca. So when I first started out, I only did VHS tapes and I practiced on some of my dad's tapes, like his wedding and some other tapes. My very first customer was my papa. So my papa gave me a full box of VHS tapes, around 50 or something. It was pretty cool because I got to watch those VHS tapes and got to see my grandpa when he was young and actually had hair. I started advertising on Facebook and Instagram, and people all around Saskatoon asked me to do their videotapes. One day, a guy asked me if I could do little videotapes and slides. I didn't tell him I had no equipment, But I said, of course, yes. That's when I decided to buy more equipment and expand. So just in the beginning of this October, we redid my website, added some new services, and tried to rank higher on Google. After all my expenses, I made a total amount of $600. I've committed to donating a portion of my profit to a charity in Guatemala for helping families and kids. So my future plans are to purchase an 8mm camcorder and to do photo and video editing. I've had lots of practice with video editing because I have a YouTube channel with my sister called Lorraine Phoenix, and we upload videos each week. We have a total of 34 videos. So if you need a video editor, call Flashback Digital. I want to thank Maureen and Gord and the Edwards School of Business for this amazing opportunity to help my business grow and to bring people's memories back to life.
Well, I understand they stopped making VHS machines, Maureen.
Yeah,
I like it. It's the grandfather brings the VHS tape. Anyways, Quinn, you want to come up? Quinn Bruton? I should have saved some of my old equipment. You want to take your mask off so we can see your face? That probably... I think I recycled it, which would be too bad because that's the players you want, don't you?
Yeah.
You want the players so you can convert them to digital. Mm-hmm. So let me just get to the important part here. The old cache. That should almost buy you a very good 8 millimeter. And you know, they're Super 8 as well as 8 millimeter. You know that, eh? Okay. Here we go, 51, 52, 53, 54, whoops, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 50, one big one.
There we go. Thank you so much.
And I know what you're going to do with it, so I don't have to ask you that. And you had some brothers that won something, didn't you?
Yes. Yeah, they're the Grass Barbers.
The Grass Barbers, and that was, I think, a couple of years ago.
I think two.
Two? Yeah, the inaugural ones, yeah. Seen something running in that family, must be the water or something. Would you say hi to them for us?
Yes.
Okay.
My brother's over there, actually, by the way.
Oh, it's hard to tell with the masks on, eh?
Congratulations.
We're going to take you out to the farm with a short hitch swather and let you play all day. Okay, now, this is the fourth group, the 16 to 18-year-old group, and this is a new category this year for us.
Hello, my name is Lachlan Kinnaird, and I own my own photography business.
Hello, I'm Adam Simpson, and I'm 13.
And I'm Noah Simpson, and I'm 17.
We are both the founders of Homeschool Dropout Apparel.
Hello, my name is Lachlan Kinnaird, and I own my own photography business. This is some of the equipment I use. So this is my Mavic 2 Pro. Is a professional grade drone that I use to take all my aerial photos. This is my Canon Rebel T5 that I use to do a lot of landscape photos and portrait photos. This is my iPhone X, which I also use for photography because it's always on me and it could be really handy in situations like this where I run into something cool and want to take a picture. So today I'm going to be showing you guys some of my personal favorite photos that I've taken, along with telling you a little bit about my business and what I do. So I run my business mostly through the summer time, but I also do a little bit of stuff through the winter. So my winter, this is me ice fishing. I often do some stuff while I'm out, like some landscape photos like these that are really cool while I'm ice fishing. But I do a lot of my business throughout the summer. So during the summer, I do a lot of contracts through realtors. I did one this year for Sass Landing Marina, and I did contract with Avid Construction, but most of my business comes through Sandy Shores Resort. So I did 37 flights for Sandy Shores Resort this summer. Most of them were photos like this, but I also did some videos of the lots where I'd get my drone up and I would do a full 360-degree circle of the lot, which actually enabled them to sell to people who had never even seen the lot before. So that was a very unique selling point. I made a total of $2,250 just from my photography this summer. If I win, I intend to put some of the money back into my business. I intend to invest or save some of it and put some of it into my car.
Come on up, Lachlan. So, Lachlan, while you're walking up here and taking your mask off, Lachlan is persistent, one of the qualities that make an entrepreneur. And how many times have you entered?
This is my third time.
Third time. And now he's fine-tuned his presentation, fine-tuned his business, and he's a winner. So if you hang in there, good things happen. So that's great. And you got
bigger prize.
Yeah, you also got bigger prize. You started out at about 750, and you've now, instead of winning the 750 or 1,000, you won the 1,500. So that's a good way of looking at it. Also, you got 4 licenses this summer?
Yeah, so I recently got my driver's license. I got a license for my drone, because now with the bunch of the new regulations that came out, you need a commercial license to fly drones. So I got that, and I also got a boater's license and a few others.
Yeah.
It's hard to keep track.
Well, that's pretty good for a summer to do all those things, especially the drone license, because it's considered an aircraft and you have to file a flight plan and do all these things. So it's very important. Sorry?
I wondered how many hours it takes to get the drone license. How many?
I did about a week of study, and then I wrote a 2-hour exam online. So it's a more difficult course because it focuses more on aviation than how to actually fly the drone, but I managed to get through it. So.
Good job.
And it's paid off. I actually did a gig this weekend with Fishing Geeks.
Oh.
And I went out and I got paid to go out ice fishing with them and take photos and videos.
So that's one of the best things about finding what you love to do. If it's fun, it's not work.
Yeah.
And then to get paid.
Yeah.
And get paid again. It gets no better. All right, this is going to take me a while. There should be 30 of these. I'm just going to count to 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So there's your 1,500. Maureen's going to put it in there if you want to put your mask on, and then we'll give you that, sweetie. Boy, you keep a messy stage, Maureen.
Well, when you have all this money, it's
just falling out of our pockets.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Initiative, finitiative, and stick-to-itiveness, I guess, all rolled into one. Now, our final group, and this is the award for Sailing the Entrepreneur Ship, and it comes with a $1,500 prize.
Ahoy, mateys! Land ho for the roadways galley!
board our ship and sail with the sails of the seven seas.
Come see the sight of our swashbuckling services.
Performing adventurous acts to provide you with your desired services.
Don't forget Buccaneers, fine dining.
The original cooks of the seven seas.
Our crow's nest trade goods.
Eyes up on the lookout, watching for the nearest port to dock and to take the ship to market.
Come, take a look at our treasure chest.
Hidden gems, items, and other valuables not found anywhere else, only brought and sold to you by the Railway's galley.
We've sailed the seven seas and conquered many storms, but over the last 8 months of the excruciating coronavirus, our crew of the Railway's galley has persevered and have shown how dedicated they are in still providing you with the best from our galley. Quick, buy now before our sails have gone to Davy Jones's locker.
So, I think I see the captain in the crowd. So, would the captain please, please come up and collect your $1,500? Sheila Erickson, and that school has an entrepreneur class, and all the kids that go there have started their own business. So, it's a really great way for the kids to learn math and salesmanship and marketing, how to get along with customers, a lot of different things.
Yeah, they do.
So we actually have two things for you. I'm going to give you the cash, and I'm going to give you a moment to maybe go into more detail, but let's get the money out of the way, you know?
I'm okay with that.
Have you got any plans for this money?
Well, we actually do. We've been looking at a Cricut machine that we thought would help all of the kids make their packaging more professional and do a bit toward the advertising of our companies.
Right, yeah. On.
Do you know what that is?
It's the sealing machine of some sort, is it?
It's more of a, Haley, what would you say?
You can kind of create a lot of different things. So the Cricut, you can cut paper, vinyl, material, and you can create things. So the kids could add their logo on t-shirts with iron press vinyl, or we can get them to make cups or tables, pegs for all their businesses, and it kind of can do
decorate their masks.
And this is your entrepreneurial crew.
It is.
So first, we'll get the cash. One, two, I'm just going to count to 30. It's a test. I do have a commerce degree. I can go up to 50. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Boy, we should make the prizes smaller. Then I'm going to have to counsel them. But before we do this and give you, we also have a plaque for your wall at school. And it's got, and this is, of course, it has Railway's Literacy Entrepreneurship Program. Sheila is the captain. And Sailing the Entrepreneurship and, of course, our Get a Bigger Wagon. And this is made by another bunch of kids, the Mr. Wass's business kids group. And someday I hope that they will have the time to enter. So they can do all sorts of things. They have a laser cutter. And this is, of course, this is made out of wood. And they use recycled kitchen cabinet doors. And then they custom paint it and so on. So going to give you, Maureen, I guess we'll have to put it all in the wagon.
Yep.
And then your plaque also for the wall. And this is the very first time we've done this award as well. So it's for people that promote entrepreneurism quietly in the community. And we're going to kind of shine a spotlight on them.
Yeah. Thank you so much, everybody. Can I take just a minute?
Sure.
And talk about our little business? Because we're a group, and we work in a small learning studio where most of our kids have a diagnosis of dyslexia. So reading and writing and math are really difficult for them, and that's why we decided to bring in entrepreneurship as a way of being hands-on and giving them the opportunity to read and write and do math with real things. And what we found, our students have extraordinary creativity as well as really great problem-solving skills, which you people would all know are so necessary for entrepreneurship. So we have kids from grade 2 to grade 8, and they all have their own businesses or are part of our larger business. But besides that, we have a great group of teachers who are equally as talented in helping those kids and bringing our program to life. So thank you very much. We're very honored to be a part of this program.
And thank you for all you do. The kids, if you ever, when things get back to normal, they have a sale every second Friday. And, you know, sometimes in a year from now or something, you know, you can drop by, look at their, they have their website and so
We'd
on.
We'd welcome
there.
You.
Yeah. So thank you,
thank
Sheila.
You.
You almost need a wagon to haul all your goodies. So let's have a big round of applause for our third annual Youth Entrepreneurial Workers and for all those who participated. And finally, I'd like to thank all of you for celebrating with us. Please stay safe and well and have a successful 2021. Hopefully, this time next year, we'll be COVID-free. We'll be back at the Edwards School. And please, once things get normal, go up to the school, Edwards, and next summer, hopefully, or the summer after, and have a look around. And hopefully, some of you young entrepreneurs will end up at the Edwards School of Business. So thank you very much, everybody. Drive safe. Thank you.